This is a story of my software engineering journey from 2015 till now, inclusive of the wins and losses, the good parts, the bad parts, the wins, and the lessons. Before the journey started, I was looking for open internship roles because it was a requirement for my computer science bachelor's degree. The internship was for 2016, but I had a place at a bank in Lagos. It was IT support and I didn't want that for myself, so I became intentional about searching for roles. In 2016, I had found a place. I had to start later in the year, and it was a new advertising agency, and I was going to be a software developer there. I was the first developer they hired. And even though I didn't know what it would feel like working alone, I was very excited to write code, and it was better than IT support to me. I started the job, and I was working with HTML and CSS a lot at the time. I hated the process, but was always proud of my work. I would tell all my friends to visit the website I had built in production, and them checking it out would make me really excited. Even if the salary was small, that didn't matter to me because I was after the good grade and the experience. I was looking forward to visiting Google for their Inside Loop program in Switzerland. Unfortunately, in 2016, during my internship, I tried to get the visa to go to Switzerland to be a part of that event, but I got denied that visa. And that was my first ever visa denial. That also happened to be the first time I applied for a visa on my own without my family. During that time, I felt bad. And because of my interest in the program, I had made friends with some Google recruiters. And I had told them I was interested in working at Google when I was done with school. In December 2016, I was to end the internship, but I had changed my mind last minute. I had a new plan: to go back to school, but keep working there as a student. My compensation didn't change, but I wanted it. I've seen what happens to many Nigerian graduates because of lack of experience, and I didn't want that to be my story. I wanted tech experience so bad, so I did it. In 2017, I was focused on school and work. It was also a lonely year for me because all my friends did four-year courses and had graduated. Mine was 5 years. I was working on my final year project, which was a software to detect copy-paste plagiarism. Working on this project exposed me to a bunch of data structures, and I got to implement a try for the first time in a live application. I called it Third Eye. I was so proud of it. Someone at work even helped with branding as a show of support. 2017 was also a very crazy year because I got a second job. I thought it was a good idea, but I didn't realize I was getting into a trap. The thing is, at my old job, I loved the people, but the work became boring, primarily because I hated front-end web development, and that was 80% of my work there. The second job was for a media company that wanted to launch a cooking show. It wasn't full-time, but they needed a full-stack developer to manage and build their websites. I thought it made sense because I would add it as back-end experience, which I liked at the time. I really liked back-end and Android development at that time. One very shocking revelation when I started the job was that they wanted me to manage their social media because their website wasn't top priority. After months of hoping I'll do the work that I liked, it wasn't forthcoming, so I quit. I was back to having school and my job at the agency. In October 2017, I wrote my final exams and defended my final year project. I was very excited.
See them, Vice is not strong. I am recording this for the whole world to know that DJ Vice is not strong.
This was the last time I was ever going to write a Unilag exam. I was ready to leave and let the world see me. 2018 was graduation. I was happy to be graduating with a first class. I was even happier that I was finally leaving Unilag and moving on with my life. In that time, I had resumed at the agency as a full-time software engineer, and my compensation was 10 times what I started with. I was taking on other kinds of work, not just front end, and I started doing other things. Around that time, I heard that some people in my class, while I was in Unilag, interviewed with Microsoft and got offers in Vancouver. I was heartbroken, mostly because no one told me. They interviewed quietly. Apparently, Microsoft had come to Unilag to do university recruiting, but I wasn't aware. I was sad, but I let it go. I then remembered that I had the contact of a Google recruiter, and then I reached out and scheduled interviews. Weeks later, I did the interviews, but I didn't do well. I was advised to try again in 6 months, but I had started doing my NYSC, which was going to take a year, so I didn't bother. I took all the feedback from my Google interview and decided to work on myself and become a better version of myself. I lacked confidence, was always afraid to speak, and as a result, couldn't open my mouth to speak whenever I was asked a question, and that cost me my interview. In October 2018, I created Adora Hack. I started writing. It was easier than speaking for me, and I wanted to share my thoughts with anyone that would read. I told my skip level manager, and he advised me to try speaking and take my LinkedIn seriously. Thankfully, I listened. I started sharing my opinion in meetings, book reviews, and discussions. It was scary because whenever I wanted to talk, everywhere would be silent. From meetings, I tried meetups and then conferences. I didn't realize people were watching. In 2019, a Microsoft recruiter reached out to me about hiring in Africa for mixed reality, and it sounded like fun. I scheduled time with him and we spoke about the role. I submitted my application, did the interviews, and got in. I quit my old job in June 2019 and resumed at Microsoft in August 2019. I was writing code on the back end with C#, and I later got pulled into some Unity and C# work. I liked the fact that I was put in an environment where I didn't know what I was doing more than half the time. That helped me learn. For a full year, I contributed to Azure Object Anchors. And in 2020, people in my team got moved to a new work stream to build a different mixed reality product. In that time, I was writing C# and working on Azure services. I was also doing infrastructure engineering, and I liked it there. Even in the pandemic, I figured out a way to make working from home work for me, my job, and my YouTube channel. I also picked up TypeScript and C++. So now at my job, I was writing three languages: C#, TypeScript, and C++. In 2021, the work we did for the whole year got announced at Microsoft Ignite, and I was filled with so much joy. I also got my first professional award, and now I can't stop talking about it. I'm still working on the cloud and learning every day. I'm excited about how far I've come, and I'm looking forward to what the future has in store for me. I'm going to keep working, keep building, and keep growing. And I look forward to sharing 10 years in my professional life with you.